Evening. Tonight, Queenslanders are being rewarded given a fresh easing of restrictions as the Chief Health Officer declares our latest outbreak averted.
Not only in time for the weekend, but another super vax blitz, putting us on track to be 70% vaccinated by early November. But some of our most vulnerable communities are trailing far behind.
It's the government's two schools of thought. Head back to the school yard and get your jab. 18 schools from Browns Plains to Bundaberg, Maryborough to Mount Isa will offer the jab.
And of course, this weekend is our big super vax weekend.
3 weeks to the day the government trialled its first super vax weekend, which resulted in over 50,000 Queenslanders being immunised.
I'm just urging people to go and get vaccinated, and also the timeline has come up from our last super vax weekend of when people are due for their second dose.
In the last 24 hours, 18,776 people rolled up their sleeves, meaning 69.3% of the state has its first dose and over 50% are now fully vaxxed, on target to 70% double doses by early November. Gundawindi leading the charge with over 85% of locals single dosed, 72.1% doubled. Here in Brisbane, almost 3 in 4 eligible residents have had their first jab, and well over half with both. Up north, Cairns is on top, with 68.7% with one, with two, 52.2%. The Sunshine Coast holds a steady lead over the Gold Coast, while Cherbourg has the state's lowest rates, with just 30% single dosed, and under 20 have had both.
Once the borders are open, there will be community spread of this virus. It will come in every single community.
But
because we've had such good news over the last week,
restrictions eased. As of 4 p.m, the southeast has moved to level 3 restrictions, which looks like this. Up to 100 people can gather in homes, and there's no limit for people gathering outdoors. Funerals and weddings can have 200 people attend. Visits allowed at aged care facilities and hospitals. Clubs, pubs, restaurants, cafes and places of worship are now back to one person per 2 square metres. And
you wear your mask going in, you check in, and then you don't need to wear your mask.
News of today's easing of restrictions, bittersweet for some. Stadiums are back to full capacity. Unfortunately, 5 days too late for those that had to forfeit their NRL grand final tickets. But despair is quickly overshadowed with yet another silver lining.
Dancing is back.
While we are seeing the easing of restrictions around masks, we're being reminded by the government we need to carry them with us wherever we go. If you're in a situation where you can't socially distance, you need to whack them on. This is the biggest easing of restrictions we've seen around the hospitality industry in some time. Here's the reminder. Once you've checked in, you can take them off and you can stand up to have a drink. As for shopping centres and public transport, the Premier wants us to use our own discretion. Again, if you're in a situation where you can't socially distance, whack your mask on. But today is a day of celebration here in Queensland. And Melissa, what better day to celebrate than the day dancing makes a comeback?
Yeah, it's good news, isn't it, Peter? Thank you. Queensland's home quarantine trial is set to start in 3 days, offering hope to those stuck interstate. 300 people have been selected so far, but there is confusion around exactly who is being let in.
Work underway at Queensland's WellCamp quarantine facility. Stephen Miles saying it won't be made redundant by home quarantine, as not everyone will qualify for it.
We anticipate there to be a continuing need for quarantine facilities.
Fully vaxxed paramedic Bryce Hill is one of many Queenslanders stuck interstate after heading to Melbourne to be with his mum Lynette as she passed away from cancer.
Thank you, Mum. We will all miss you.
He was overjoyed to receive an email on Wednesday from Queensland Health inviting him to participate in the home quarantine trial, especially given he meets all the criteria.
I was so over the moon. I was so beauty that there's a light at the end of the tunnel.
But yesterday he received another email from Queensland Police saying, with respect to the home quarantine trial, the QPS will contact potential participants in this chronological order and offer positions in the trial until the maximum number of participants have been reached. The emails had no contact details, leaving Bryce unsure as to whether he is or isn't coming home.
I was confused. I was angry. I was disappointed there was no phone number. I wanted to ring someone and just say, hey, is this right? Is this correct?
Queensland residents wanting to come back, then the Queensland Police Service is working with them, and also Queensland Health's working on the exemption units. We're working hand in hand.
While the home quarantine trial is a step forward for some, there are still thousands stuck over the border who don't qualify for the program and are asking the question, when will they be allowed in? What's being done to bring them home?
Yep, so what we're doing is we're doing the first 1,000, and if that works really well, then of course we're going to extend that trial. But like Dr. Young said, one step at a time.
The Premier says more announcements are likely after the next National Cabinet on November 5. Now, Queensland Health has just contacted me about Bryce Hill's case. They are unaware of what he's been sent by Queensland Police and say this can happen when people have separate border pass and exemption requests. But their advice to him is just respond to the health email and not the police one. Andrew, Melissa, no wonder there's a bit of confusion.
Yeah. Ignore the police in that instance. All right, Tim, thank you.